Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Now, dal form in Arabic language, al-muthanna. Introduction. In this lesson, we will learn the following, inshallah, the dal form al-muthanna of the Arabic nouns. The form that relates to two of something. This is very important within the Arabic language and is used frequently. Al-mufradu, al-mudarrisu, the teacher, singular, al-mudarrisu, al-muthanna, al-mudarrisani, to teacher, al-jam'u, al-mudarrisuna, the teachers, plural, al-mu'annathu, al-mufrad, al-mudarrisatu, the teacher, singular, al-muthanna, al-mu'annath, al-mudarrisatani, two teachers, feminine. We will also learn the dal form of the demonstrative pronoun for the near object is for both the masculine and the feminine objects. المذكر المفرد هذا this masculine المذكر المثنى هذان these two. الجمع هؤلاء these all المفرد هذه these feminine المؤنث المثنى هاتان these two الجمع هؤلاء these all. And we will learn the dull form of the personal pronoun for the said person. المذكر المفرد هو he المذكر المثنى هما they two المذكر الجمع هم they all المؤنث المفرد هي she المثنى هما they two الجمع هن they all feminine. Zadal al-muthanna. In Arabic, nouns fall into three categories, namely singular, which relates to a single noun, dal, which indicates two of something, plural, which indicates more than two of something. In order to change singular Arabic noun to the dal, the following steps are involved: nominative, to change a singular masculine noun to the case of dal, the following changes occur. The last letter of the word has its vowel replaced with single fatha, replacing dhamma or dhammati. Like the suffix of any is added to the word. See some examples of clue. Talibun will become talibani. At-talibu will become at-talibani. To change a singular feminine noun with nominative case to the dal, the following change occurs. The last letter ta marbuta is changed to letter ta. The last letter ta has its vowel replaced with a single fatha, dhamma, dhammatain. The suffix of an is added to the word. See some example too. Talibatun will become talibatani. Al-talibatu will become al-talibatani. genitive and accusative case to change a single masculine noun with accusative or genitive case to the dal, a single fatha is added on the last letter instead of the accusative case with fatha or genitive case with kasra. The suffix talibaini sukun and noun with kasra is added. See some examples. Blue ma'a mudarrisin will become ma'a mudarrisaini. عند المدرس will become عند المدرسين. To change a singular feminine noun with an accusative or genitive case to the dal, the last letter ta marbuta is changed to ta, letter ta. A single fatha is added on the last letter instead of the accusative case with fatha or genitive case with a kasra. The suffix yen with ya wa noon, ya with sukun and noon with a kasra is added. See some examples below. Fi haqibatin, fi haqibataini, fi haqibatin will become في حقيبتين. فوق الشجرة will become فوق الشجرتين. Let's look at some more examples for a better understanding of the rule. أخ في البيت, in Arabic, أخ في البيت, a brother in the house. أخواني في البيت, the two brothers in the house. أخ في البيت, the brother in the house, a brother in the house. أخواني في البيت, two brothers in the house. بنتان مع مدرسة, two daughters with a teacher. Two daughters with a teacher. بنتان مع مدرستين, two daughters with two teachers. بنتان مع مدرستين, two daughters with two teachers. كتاب في الحقيبة, a book in the bag, a book in the bag. كتابان في الحقيبتين, two books in the two bags, two books in the two bags. كتاب في الحقيبة, a book in the bag. كتابان في الحقيبتين, two books in the two bags. In this part of lesson, however, we will learn the dal from the demonstrative pronoun for the nerbi objective representing the masculine and the feminine nouns, inshallah. In order to change the demonstrative pronoun for the near objective to the dal form, the following steps are involved. To change demonstrative pronoun for the near objective representing a masculine noun to musanna, dal form, ni. Noon with a kasra. Hadani. Hada will become hadani. Hada will become hadani. To change a demonstrative pronoun for the near objective representing feminine noun hadihi to muthanna dal form, the last letter ha is changed to the letter ta and the single kasra is replaced with a single fatha and the suffix alif, noon, ani, long vowel alif and noon with a kasra. Hadihi will become hatani. Hadihi will become hatani. هذا قلم. This is a pen. This is a pen. هذان قلمان. These are two pens. هذان قلمان. هذه بنت. هذه بنت. This is a girl. These are. هذه بنت. This is a girl. هاتاني بنتاني. These are two girls. These are two girls. هذا الولد عند أبيك. This boy is with your father. This boy is with your father. هذا الولد عند أبيك. هذان الولدان عند أبيك. These two boys are with your father. هذان الولدان عند أبيك. These two boys are with your father. هذا الباب مغلق. This door is closed. This door is closed. هذان البابان مغلقان. These two doors are closed. هذان البابان مغلقان. These two doors are closed. This is part of the lesson. We will learn the dull form of the personal pronoun for the third person representing the masculine and the feminine nouns, inshallah. In order to change the personal pronoun for the third person representing masculine and the feminine nouns to the dull form, the following steps are involved to change personal pronoun for the third person representing a masculine huwa to musanna dull form. The last letter wa with a fatha is replaced ma mim with fatha and the long vowel alif. Huwa will become huma. Huwa will become huma. Huwa talibun. He's a student. هما طالبان. They both are students. هو طالب. He is a student. هما طالبان. They both are students. هي مدرسة. She is a teacher. هما مدرستان. They are both teachers. هي مدرسة. She is a teacher. هما مدرستان. They are both teachers. هذا الولد فقير وهو يتيم أيضا. هذا الولد فقير وهو يتيم أيضا. This boy is poor. He is an orphan as well. هذا الولد فقير وهو يتيم أيضا. This boy is poor. He is an orphan as well. هذان الولدان فقيران. هما يتيمان أيضا. These two boys are poor. They are both orphan as well. هذان الولدان فقيران. هما يتيمان أيضا. These two boys are poor. They are both orphan as well. هذه البنت طالبة. هي مجتهدة جدا. This girl is a student. She is very hardworking. هذه البنت طالبة. هي مجتهدة جدا. This girl is a student. She is a hardworking. هاتان البنتان طالبتان. هما مجتهدتان جدا. These two girls are students. They are both very hardworking. هاتان البنتان طالبتان. هما مجتهدتان جدا. These two girls are students. They are both very hardworking. Exercise. In this section, we will have multiple questions to test your understanding of the principles we have learned, inshallah. حول المبتدأ في كل من الجمل الآتية إلى المثنى كما في المثال. The Arabic sentences above me change the subject of each of the foreign sentences to dull form. هذا كتاب. هذان كتابان. هذه مسطرة. هاتان مسطرتان. هذا قلم. هذان قلمان. هذه سيارة. هذان سيارتان.